we have reached a crucial juncture in our history. We are on the threshold of a new stage of social, cultural, and spiritual evolution. We are evolving toward an interconnected, information-based global system that straddles the planet. The challenge we now face is to choose our destiny. Our generation is called upon to create a peaceful and cooperative global society, and thereby continuing the grand adventure of life, spirit, and consciousness on Earth.
The new humanism proposed by Nina Bokova, Director General of UNESCO, is a call for a new consciousness of the main challenge of our time in order to create a global society. The Gaia Project, following the aims of the new humanism, intends to give theoretical and practical instruments to realize a more conscious, peaceful, and sustainable society. The Gaia Project develops the national guidelines of the Italian Ministry of Education, Research and University to promote educational programs aiming to realize a global society.
Consciousness is the core of every human being, and the realization of a new global society requires a new global consciousness of ourselves and of our complex world. Here in the Villaggio Globale, Villa Dedico, our institute has been working with an equipe of doctors, teachers, psychologists, university professors to create this global consciousness educational program. We strongly believe that in order to create a new global society, we need a new global educational system that first of all enhances the sense of consciousness, the sensitivity that we have, that can give us some basic ethic value, a new scientific understanding, so we can see the world not in a fragmentary way, but as a unity with nature and human being. With these new tools, we can really create all together a new, more peaceful, sustainable, and ethical society. The Global Consciousness Education Project has four main principles. At the center of the whole project are the techniques that improve and deepen the experiences of self-consciousness. The project is based on the United Nations and UNESCO ethic principle written in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, on the Earth Charter, which highlights the global ecological and sustainable principles, and on the Manifesto of Planetary Consciousness. The project provides a simple understanding of the scientific holistic paradigm, the information that promotes a more unitary, systemic understanding of human being and of the whole world. The aim of the project is the practical realization of those inner ethical and scientific insights that should have a direct positive impact on our ways of living, working, and producing. We primarily use conscious breathing techniques such as mindfulness because they are very easy to learn, they have no side effects, and especially because they have deep positive effects on mental, emotional, and physical health. In the last 10 years, more than 2,400 international scientific researchers have highlighted the positive effects of the conscious breathing techniques, in particular reducing stress, anxiety, depression, promoting the balancing between hormones, enhancing the activity of the immune system, increasing the kindness and empathy, which are the keys of family and social life, and improving memory and cognitive learning function. The brain of a person in a state of stress or normal consciousness shows low EEG coherence, while in a state of global consciousness the brain increases coherence and synchronization. Two people in a state of self-consciousness are synchronized and feel in empathy and in a space of collaboration. This also happens in groups of people as they move from a normal state to a state of self-consciousness. synchronize their brain waves and make them feel part of a more loving, consistent, and mutually reinforcing group. These are the basis of a different way to live and to work in a global society.
The new paradigm in education, I would like just to highlight the central, the core importance of the self, the perception of our own life. And we are working since many years with Erwin and with many researchers, scientists, university professors, because we strongly believe that our society, our whole world is really changing so fast, and we really don't have, we are all the culture we have got from the past is really fragmentary. Different religion, different structure, different politics, different races, different religions. Now everything goes together, and but we don't have yet the ground, the cultural, scientific ground to start a global civilization. So the new paradigm is like this basic ground, the common ground. And just remember that in order to have our body living and balancing itself, we need that each of our cells have the same information, have the same pattern. No? The DNA have the same structure, and then each of our cells have a different role, a different attitude and different functions. But we all feel to be part of a large wholeness, a planetary wholeness. Let's say I will not go through the information, I will just make information and just feel the sense. This program, we teach to children in the elementary school from 6 years on. We teach it at the campus, at the university in different city, and to old people, even to very sick people in hospital, in cardiopathic person, in jail. So it's not just working on, let's say, with a well-known and a well-being person, but it's working in a strong and hard condition. Just see, we start new paradigm, how consciousness, the feeling, the idea, the search for consciousness in a scientific way, have moved all through each single scientific field. And we don't see that this revolution is already happening. But if you're not really attentive to each of field, you lose the vision. So this presentation, I would like just to show you how the consciousness revolution is happening in a different field of science. Let's start from quantum physics. Three main words: entanglement, coherence, non-locality. And just Eugene Wigner, Nobel Prize for Physics, consciousness is the primary reality. Max Planck, I regard matter as derived from consciousness. Einstein, the quantum field is infinite, but quantum field is me, is each of my atoms, particle. Schrödinger, quantum entanglement, that means everything is connected. The old vision in physics of Newton was like atoms are single like balls, physical atoms. Moving, getting together, or bumping into each other. Now, matter doesn't exist anymore in physics. There is something like matter. There is mass, but basically there is just energy. And energy is information. Energy means information. Some people say energy is just the way we call it, the flux of information. Information is consciousness. So if we have a deeper look of quantum physics, we don't see anymore the division matter and spirituality. We see the wholeness moving and breathing and evolving. David Bohm, a colleague of Einstein, quantum field of consciousness, he called it really holistic field around every particle or particle. And so there is consciousness even at the quantum level. We are using, according to the idea of David Bohm and other physicists, and even of Laszlo, we use this definition of consciousness that is a revolution, because if we apply the consciousness as the field system capacity to understand the meaning of information and interact with it, that means that my computer doesn't have consciousness. Is interacting with information, but that does not get any understanding of the meaning. You can put in the computer everything and there is no understanding of the meaning of the information. But every living being, even stones, even planets, even trees, are full of consciousness. They are all living systems that interact and get the meaning of their own information, even a singular unicellular being. This was a very friend of mine, and he died. He was a physicist at the University of High Energy in Milan. And he and Emilio Giuliano Preparata have developed the idea of coherence. Coherence means when the wave of energy are getting together, and when they are coherent, they exchange information, they share information. So life is growing out of coherence. A cell is a world that have inside 100,000 atoms, and they are coherent as a wholeness. And if we understand the coherent pattern in physics, then we can teach children, adults, politicians, doctors, or business people how to improve coherence and do their own business according to the wholeness. And coherence is this laser beam. All the information of the single photons are getting together, they create a whole field. And we will see that this is happening even in our brain. This was the other friend of mine, and he said that oneness, this coherence is the law of the oneness of our universe and ourself. And I would just like to imagine that according to those information that comes from quantum physics, like we are here, just in the middle, this is the demigod, and it's just energy. And down we have all the planetary, ground, earth energy, and from space, sun, stars, and all is connected, and we are just somehow moving our energy and connecting and creating a field, and the field are in deep resonance with other fields like us. New paradigm, the epigenetic in biology and evolution, the epigenetic revolution, National Geographic. Just see the number of scientific research on epigenetic. What is epigenetic? It's like our DNA is like a piano with all keys. You can play some of the keys and some not. Epigenetic is how are the keys you play, and sometimes you play the right key and it's a beautiful music. But if a monkey comes on the piano, it's like polyphonic music. And we develop this incredible pattern of evolution, not just by chance. Evolution by chance is something that science is seeing that is a very wrong concept. Evolution is like a co-evolution. It's evolution of quantum unity, of quantum particle, and then quantum atoms, they get together and create a cell, and cell get together and create a multicellular. And maybe we can do this job. All living being and human being can create a quantum leap of consciousness and become aware to be citizen of this planet. And this is the Gaia consciousness, the planetary consciousness. David Gabronka is a professor at the Tel Aviv University, and he's just showing in hundreds of research that the information, the emotions, the consciousness from the mother is going to the son, but even to the nephew. So it's just two, three generations that the information is passed. It's not just by chance. There is a flux of information, of knowledge. Let's go fast on this because it's a very complex situation, but we can study the quantum, the general system theory in a very different way. This is like the atomic vision, the old material vision, separate from consciousness, but we can all see that particles, atoms, cells, human being, planet, and the wholeness of the universe have consciousness, is deeply conscious. And this is changing completely our vision. And we can see all through the passage, but this is not the time. Okay, the new paradigm in neuroscience, the consciousness revolution. This was Francis Crick, who got the Nobel Prize in medicine because he discovered the DNA double helix. And he said, for first, consciousness is the legitimate field of scientific research. Before him, science had to study just material function, and he said, no, consciousness, now we can study consciousness. And in order to study consciousness, we have to see the wholeness of the brain. It's not one object we have to study. It's a function, is a process, and is a global process. So we have to understand the totality of the system. After him, Paul McLean started to say, well, but in order to understand consciousness, we should understand the evolution of consciousness. Because it's not like a Christian tradition that God came and created consciousness, a human being, and all the other animal doesn't have any consciousness. Is a growing process, is an evolutive process. And if we see the three brain, how they evolve in animal and in human being, there is an incredible growth of the neocortical brain. So our consciousness has to be clearly understood as a body consciousness, as emotional consciousness, and a mental consciousness. I am all my body feeling, I am my emotion and my ideas and my knowledge. But I am more than everything I said. I am one. And science now can give us incredible understanding of this oneness. And the Nobel Prize in Medicine, Edelman, say consciousness is a network of coherent information. Consciousness is not, again, an object, but it's the function of all the brain, and he forget the body, all the brain, body, you know, psychosomatic unity, and the energy, the coherent information create what we call it, me, the self, my consciousness. The thalamus, he discovered that the thalamus is giving information 40 times every second and is connecting with all the neocortex and is balancing and synchronizing the whole information. So we think, we feel, we smell, we test, and everything could be separated, but there is a center of synchronization that gets everything in one. So we feel our world, ourselves. Is a great scientist who was here 4 years ago, and he discovered that we share the same basic consciousness that every animal has, and we share even the same basic emotional stuff of animals. in the same part of the brain. So rage, sex, fear, pleasure, care, play, seeking are the same function in every brain. The only difference is like in red there is this reptilian brain. Reptilian animals have just this lower kind of structure and motion. In red we have mammalian brains, and they have play system and care system and a grief system that reptilian doesn't have. And we have two more neocortical hemisphere that are differentiate us. This is a map, is the most evolved map that is getting together 3,500 research on neurotransmitter and consciousness and emotional studies in a very simple map. We are using this in medical and psychosomatic and psychology, and it's so easy to use and is giving a different vision of everything. In traditional medicine, these emotional systems are called the Shen, the Ben Shen, the different, the fear, love, sex, were already understood by the Chinese medicine. But still, Pamsett and Norton, this guy, incredible guy is Norton, discovered that in the middle part of the brain, they call it cortical, this part, and subcortical midline structures, there is a flux, a very important flux of information. And just see the, what they discover. Pamsett discovered that in the lower part of the brain, there is the corporeal self. Reptilian have already one center of self in body consciousness in the lower part of the brain. And then we have body consciousness, emotional self, and cognitive self. We have this cortical midline system. But this is exactly the map of Chinese Tibetan yogic old medicine. So out of this information we can revolutionize the, our system in medicine, in psychology, and these are just the same in Indian tradition, in Chinese tradition, in Tibetan tradition. And we discovered since years that the same level are the dermatomeri, that are anatomical structure of the spine. And so we are working with doctor with a very high level. And quantum consciousness and brain, Stuart Amerov and Theo Rosa say that the microtubules works as a synchronizer of the cell informations. But just imagine our electromagnetic quantum field, and let's see what happens when we understand the waves. So exactly like the brain, the laser, even the brain is doing exactly the same pattern of coherence. So no coherence, stressed person, brain of the stressed person, a brain of a meditating person. The synchronization goes from basic zero to 96% of coherence. So we can learn how and how to teach people to get all the energy and intelligence they can have. And this is the coherence in severe depression mind and light depression, normal person, and in meditation. So coherence is an instrument, a fantastic instrument. And we can train people just to move from severe depression to a very healthy state. But what happened between two people? Two people just talking, no change between their own brains, no entanglement. And two people in meditation or in love. So what you were saying, creating a loving classroom is absolutely working. And we see that without heart, the mindfulness or meditation is really low efficacy. Love without mindfulness still is working, but the two together are really doing a good job. Okay, but more, 12 people, we measure just 12 people because we don't have enough money to make a larger instrument. We did it all with our smaller resource, economical resources. And you see, 12 people before and after. This is a collective consciousness field. That means that the people were really like creating a unified field. But this means peace on earth. Means that if we can teach a student, a children, adult, how to create this harmonic field. It's intuitive, we know it already, but it's much different if we have a scientific proof, no? We can work much better, people can listen to us much, with more attention. So when the brain is harmonized, then the axis is harmonized and the health happens with very little economical effort. The Shen, the global self awareness, is creating a field. So all our information from different parts of our brain get together, become one. This is why consciousness is at the center of the new paradigm. The paradigm in medicine, this is a white blood cell. They discovered that in a white blood cell, there are all the neurotransmitter, receiver and transmitting of the brain, of the neurons of the brain. So it's like our immune system is a liquid brain, but each cell have not maybe all of them, but some neurotransmitter. So each cell have consciousness and is dealing with information, more or less. Candice Bert was here 5 years ago, and unfortunately she died, and she discovered endorphin and neurotransmitter, and who was the first that had published an article on science, on psychosomatic neural network. Human being is a psychosomatic world. There is no more possible separation between mind, body and consciousness. He discovered that neurotransmitters are molecules of emotions. So the world is going, and the self, if you change yourself, you change the psycho-neuro-endocrine-immunological structure that is changing the epigenetic and then the genetic information. Just see what self-consciousness, that is basically just doing nothing, just be aware of yourself. Not doing anything. It's just watch yourself inside, outside, watch your breath, you watch your body, your feeling. Just in a space of a normal state, you can do everything. And just this is reducing stress hormones. It's a cortisol and adrenaline goes down, increase hormones like endorphin that make us feel good. Increase hormone of affectivity and kindness, the oxytocin, is improving the immune system, is increasing hormone that reduce depression, is increasing serotonin and dopamine, is reducing inflammation and blood pressure, heart activity, muscular and nervous tension. So it's like an incredible tools we can use, and is absolutely scientific, is no more related with all the tradition of any kind. So it's like we can teach him to every atheistic, not atheistic, a Christian, doesn't matter who he is, it's just do it, and it's working. In our map we put the self, this is the self, the totality of the self, and we show that many diseases, most of the diseases like stress, anxiety and depression are coming from a very low level of serotonin that is coming 90% from the belly. So we use the first part of our method is like to reduce the stress. and we put many techniques and we study many research and we use all the best technique, most simple and efficacy technique. When the body self is back again, grounded, then the energy comes to the heart, serotonin comes, and just to feel more better. And then you work with psychology on emotional level, and you get back again to your totality. The new paradigm of consciousness in psychology, the mindfulness revolution. This is the mindfulness revolution time. The most well-known world magazine, The Science of Meditation. And this means that consciousness, self-consciousness is mainstream. We are not really, understanding, but it's mainstream. Kabat-Zinn, Siegel, they did the first step by taking all traditional technique of meditation and making mindfulness scientific, no more need to old pattern and philosophy. And since then they did this, you see the publication on just on scientific publication, rise up. Now we are basically here. This is 2014. And now we are basically here on top. The new paradigm of consciousness and the global consciousness revolution. I don't know if you know this guy, but he's an incredible person. He is creating now the planetary consciousness network, and you are part of this incredible connection. In every part of the world there are people like us, but we don't know each other. We miss each other. Everything is having incredible knowledge of so many people, so many situations, university, and can create this unique kind of network, consciousness, a new paradigm network. So there are many other things that have done, but I'm really great and thank to what he is doing now. And we are definitely writing a piece of our story, the planetary history, a moment in which everything can go, even now can go down and collapse, or can rise to a new level of organization. And the step is through our consciousness and to all the information, scientific, technical, economical, political information that can spread this message. But this is like Davos when it started, no? There are moments in history, in the culture and science, where people of the same idea get together. And it's like a fertilization, they grow together. And there is a square in mathematics. It's many people go together, it's not like one plus the other. There is a curve, an exponential curve that is rising when many people get together. Paul Ray, he discovered the idea of cultural creative, and he was here in 2001, and we did together in Italy, France, in USA, in Japan, in Hungary, research on cultural creative, seeing that is an incredible number of people creating a new economy, new ideas, a new need of a new kind of an education. And if the curve is going normally, we will reach the 51%. That means that the politics is changing by year 2020-2025. But if we work as we are working, we use a Gaia Project, the new paradigm in education, we can hope to transmit this information to other teachers. And we can get a little faster to reach this point. because something, a collapse of the economy can happen. You know that the numbers of the main economy say that what is the real, let's say, amount of money of the whole industry of the world is, let's say, hundreds. But what is in banks or is sold is 4,000. So there is an incredible difference. And this can mean that like the subprime in the United States sometimes can collapse. So it's much easier to work a little faster and better. Then the sixth degree of separation, every young people knows that we are connected, and there is between all of us in the world through internet, there is just five people from all of each. James Lovelock, the Gaia hypothesis, the Earth is a living being. From this we took the Gaia project. We put the shell, the self-awareness, in the middle of the structure. And science, global principle, the intuitive and ethical and the practice. Stuff, all good practice. Health, in emotional intelligence, in relation, in ecology, sustainability, leader in business, practical. So get together all the main stuff. And we developed this psychosomatic mindfulness protocol that is working very well. And we use the guideline of the United Nations, of the UNESCO and the World Health Organization. We follow the Agenda 2030. And the life skills. And in Italy we work with a lot of doctors and schools that are promoting this health promotion and life skills. The practice of mindfulness is very easy. The difference between us and the American way of mindfulness is just we use much more our body than our heart. Because we are all very too much in our mind and thinking. If we don't are able to stop a little the mind and to open much more the heart and the body feeling, then mindfulness happens. It's not only an observation from the mind to my breath, but it's just being in my breathing. It's oneness. And very easy to learn, no side effect, awakening the deeper sense of being in the body, no judgment here and now. And even the children of 6 years learn in half an hour, and they get deeper. When kids in the school in Lucca, we teach them, was 5 years and a half, and just went home and said, "Daddy, do you know mindfulness?" And then say, "No, you know, what is this? Oh, you don't know mindfulness." No, it's very easy. I can teach you. Just close your eyes, listen your breath. And he put the father on the chair. They did together mindfulness. And we teach in this Gaia project a little bit of everything we show you we have shown since up to now. Like a little bit of quantum physics and brain and system and Gaia and ecology. And we did some small video, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, that is the time of intellectual learning. And then the rest of the hour is just experience. So we developed, for example, ecology. Everybody knows that we have not to throw material all over. But we developed some technique, and we make every children and every person, every adult person, just to feel to be in planet. Just feel, no? North, south pole, north pole, around, and then you turn, the night, the light, the sun. Wow, this is a Nitamo planet. Fantastic. Everybody can feel, and it's easy to feel, and you know, we did even in some conference. Ah, sí, very good. You feel it? I feel it, yes. And then just ask yourself, but are you a very good leader? leader of your little world. In China, the Shen was the emperor of your system. Are you a good emperor? Or your body is sick and feeling bad and tired, and your heart is closed, and your body doesn't have any. Are you giving to your world a good food or just junk food? Are you smoking cigarette and drinking alcohol and using pills or whatever? Or you just use organic food? Or are you just opening to the heart, to the good people, and sharing good or you are not happy in your relationship with your friends? And what are you looking at the television? Just Schwarzenegger, or war films? Or you just choose the best films or program they can, from where you can learn something that. So you are very bad. So we ask them, so how to change the government instead of making a bloody revolution outside? How we can change our own, first our own world? And people say, well, I don't know. But it's not so difficult. Just imagine, and we do like 10 minutes mindfulness with open heart, feeling the whole body, and you feel like if you learn to stay in a self-conscious state, what is changing in your life? How could change your life very easily without changing anything? Just changing your center. And you say, wow, it's true. Was something people happen like you asked to write down today, no? If you open your heart, you say, well, I could love myself much more. I could love other people. I could work in a better way, in a more easy and sustainable way. So, okay, let's give us, let's say, 5 years to change government, to learn how to, not because we go back to that our head, that is a dictatorial government, but let's go back to the heart. Let's learn how to stay in our heart, how to stay in a conscious state. And it's working, see. And these are some results on depression, anxiety, somatization. We did a lot of research with very good result on hostility. With this 12-hour program, we teach the teacher, and the teacher goes to the school or to the hospital and do 12-hour program too. No? And in 12 hours we have very interesting, excellent results. And it's a natural state. Just children and adults learn how to stay, how to be what you are, how to open the heart. And we use all ancient techniques in a very scientific and simple way. How to share, how to touch, how to increase the body feeling, how to open the deep feeling. And in our, we reached 230,000 downloads in our website since 3 years. People can download all this practice from home. So even old people all over the Italy place. And this is 20,000 people in 3 years. This is the degree of satisfaction. People say it was helpful if this deep training, but wow, it's nothing, but it's 1 hour every week. But people like it, and people say, you see, very much or very important. And this is a citizen, planetary citizen diploma. At the end of this small course, we give to all the students or people a diploma. So you are a planetary citizen. You can do. And we teach them that we are interconnected, so we have to learn how to become active actor of this huge change, of this planetary transformation. this was in Rome, at the Chamber of Deputies, in China, in Budapest, in the island del Hierro. And tomorrow, next year, I would like really to invite you to this conference. We take one every last weekend of May. And this is one of the three rooms, the other are on the side. And to do maybe one whole meeting on the new paradigm. And if you want to know more from our website, www.nitamo.eu, you can download for free in English these two films and see more information. Thank you very much.